Hi guys, welcome to Excel Vlogs. My name is NS Excellence and this is a Christian lifestyle channel. Today we are going to be praying scripture. We're going to be praying 1 Corinthians 13.
I wanna set the world on fire until it's burning bright for you. It's everything that I desire. Can I be the one you
So 1 Corinthians 13 talks about love, and it's written by our amazing Apostle Paul, where he's talking about what love really is and the attributes of love. In the New Testament, we are told time and time and time again to walk in love. Jesus said that by this will they know that you are my disciples, when you love one another. You know, he talked a lot about love. I'm talking about Jesus. He talked so much about love, and he even summarized the whole commandment and all the laws in one: loving your neighbor as yourself. So this brought me to the place where I figured that if I'm not walking in love, then I'm breaking every other instruction that God has laid down. And love is not just an action. Love is not just what you do or act to somebody or say that you feel towards somebody. Love is in nature. And that's why in Galatians 5:22 it says that, but the fruit of the spirit is love. I'll stop there. Love. It started with love. So love is not just something you try to imbibe. It's not just something you try to do. Oh, I'm just gonna try to love. It is in nature. And Romans 12:2 says, be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. So how do I become a person of love? One, by renewing my mind with the word of God about love. What is God's word saying about love? What does love mean in God's word? And another thing to remember is that 2 Corinthians 3:18 explains how that as we behold the glory of God, we are being changed into the very image of God. And so that's why it is important that we pray the nature of love. We pray that God, that nature is manifested, that the Holy Spirit is already in you, and every fruit of the Spirit, you have the ability to live out every one of the fruit of the Spirit, every one of the attributes of the fruit of the Spirit. So what you need to do is to subject your own body, subject your own will to that nature that is already in you. It's not something we are trying to bring from somewhere into ourselves. We already have that nature in us, and we just have to let the Holy Spirit produce the attribute through us. So today we're going to be praying 1 Corinthians 13, and I pray in the name of Jesus. Now, as we continually pray these prayers, that will be love personified, that people will look at us, people would, you know, think of us and say, oh my God, this person is living out the love life. This person is walking in absolute love, and that by our love, people will be brought into Christ. By our love, the gospel will spread even before we open our mouths to speak. Hallelujah. So I would like you to go to 1 Corinthians 13, and before we begin the prayer, we're just going to read the first three verses, which tell you about what just love really is. It says, though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels, but have not love, I have become sounding brass or a clanging cymbal, just noise, basically. And though I have the gift of prophecy and understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, but have not love, I am nothing. And though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, I mean, what really is a show of love? I mean, if I go out right now and I give my things to the poor and I really take care of people, people will say that, oh my God, this person is full of love. But the Bible is saying that that is not where the love lies. It's saying that, and though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, listen, and though I give my body to be burned, and sorry, but have not love, it profits me nothing. So I started to think, I mean, for somebody that gave his body to be burned, what do you call that? That is love. Like, humanly speaking, that is the greatest amount of love. Like, how many of you guys can actually die? I mean, I don't mean all the things you send in your texts and all the mushy things you do. I mean, like, would you actually take a grenade for somebody you love? Would you actually die for somebody you love? Now, this place is saying that even if you did that, that still wasn't the love. And I'm like, what? Did I read it and came to his understanding? I'm like, what? So love is deeper. Love is not just the actions. Love is not just the giving to the poor. Love is not just the being nice to everybody. Love is not just being forgiving. Love is not just, you know, being so sacrificial. Love is deeper than that. And that's why I started with saying that it is a nature. It's not just something you do. It is a nature. And it has to stem from the presence of the Spirit of God in you. So it will mean that, you know, I could do all the things that sound like love or feel like love, and to God, it is still not love. You remember in John, somewhere in John, it says that whoever does not know God, like, you cannot love. But by the world's standards, I mean, there's so many couples that don't know Christ and it looks like they're in love and they're working in, like, they've been together for 50 years and they're strong and going. But the Bible is saying it is not love. We should probably look for another name to call it, because by the Bible standards, that is not love. So let me continue. It says, love suffers long. And you know the greatest truth is that God is love. So there's no love outside of God. So whatever it is you're showing to somebody outside of God, it's not love. And that's why your motives for loving should stem from a drive from God. You should not just, you know, do things for people so that, okay, they can praise you or they can remember that you are so amazing and good. But because maybe God directed you, it must be God driven, God motivated, God led. Praise God. So let's start. I pray in the name of Jesus for everyone watching this, that a fruit of the Spirit, of which one is love, will be manifested in you in the name of Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll be able to suffer long. I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll be kind. I pray in the name of Jesus that you'll not be taken over by envy. You will not parade yourself or be puffed up. You will not behave rudely or seek your own. You will be sacrificial in all your ways. I pray in the name of Jesus that you are not easily provoked. I pray in the name of Jesus that you allow the attribute of love, you allow the Holy Spirit to produce this love through you in the name of Jesus. I pray in the name of Jesus that you will think no evil, that you will not rejoice in iniquity, but you will rejoice in the truth. You will be able to bear all things. You'll be able to believe the best of people. You'll be able to hope all things, endure all things. You will not fail. Your love will not fail, because love never fails. Even when other things fail, even when prophecies fail, your love will not fail in the name of Jesus. I pray for everyone watching this that you'll be subject. You'll be subject to the Spirit of God, that you will allow him to produce that nature out of you. By human reasoning, by human standards, we know that you cannot do this on your own. So God, we are asking in the name of Jesus for every single person that, Lord, they are able to allow your Spirit to produce love, because this is the greatest command that you have given us. And it is your utmost desire that we are able to live out what you want us to live out. And so, God, we ask for your help. We ask that we are dependent on your Spirit. We ask that we are not easily provoked, but we allow your love to reign in the name of Jesus. Thank you, because all our actions are motivated by you. Thank you, because all our actions, all our sacrifices, I'm motivated by you, not for selfish gain, not for ulterior motives, but to live for you and so that we obey you in the name of Jesus. So guys, I want you to keep reading 1 Corinthians 13. renew your mind continually about what God's word is saying concerning love. God is love, and he is able to produce every attribute of love through you. Thank you guys so much for watching. I pray that God blesses you and that you keep, you know, obeying God's spirit and walking with him. The Bible says that walk in the spirit and you will not fulfill the lust of the flesh. So whatever fleshly desires you're struggling with, is it anger, is it wanting your own way, is it easily being provoked or anything, I pray in the name of Jesus that you're able to walk in the spirit and you're able to live out that life of Christ and bring people to the kingdom. Praise God. For in Jesus' name have you prayed. Amen. Thank you guys so much for watching. God bless you. Bye.